Hello. Okay, so my brain is on fire because I just left Korean class and he hit us with like the paragraphs. So he wanted us to like speak full sentences and paragraphs, and I was like dying inside. I'm still dying inside. And next week we have a test. So love that for me. But today I wanted to do a reading vlog, and I'm going to be reading Full Disclosure, which I haven't started yet, but I do have the book. I got it from the library. So I'm going to go to one of my favorite bookstores out here in Atlanta. It's called The Read Shop. I'm gonna go there. I'm probably gonna read for like an hour, and then I have to go to the library to return books. And I don't know if it's because I got these books from the library, but your girl was on fire this month. Like, I read through all of those books, no hesitation. Maybe it's because I had like a kind of a deadline to turn them back in, and I don't like checking books out and not finishing them, or like starting something and not finishing it. So I'm like determined to finish all of those books. That and all of the books I read this month were so good. Like, a couple of them were just like okay, but for the most part my reading month has been amazing, and I'm just like so happy. I found a couple of new favorite books, and I'm excited for this one because my best friend Ness just finished it and they loved it, so I think I'm gonna love it too. I really want to dive in. I'm actually also reading I Wish You All the Best, and I'm reading Riot. I'm like halfway through Riot, and it's a short read, but I feel like for me to get like the full impact of that story, I feel like I need to read it twice. So far I'm like three chapters into I Wish You All the Best, and I'm halfway through Riot Baby, and so far I really like both. So yeah, that's where I'm at. And of course, instead of finishing one of the other two books I'm reading, I'm gonna start a third one. Why do I do this to myself? But I Wish You All the Best, I'm listening to an audiobook, so honestly I'm probably gonna listen to that during the week at work. And then Riot Baby, I'll probably alternate between the two. Full disclosure, I feel like it's gonna be a 5-star read. I feel like it's gonna be really impactful and insightful and educate me a lot about people that are living with HIV. And if you don't know, Full Disclosure follows this teenage girl who has just moved to a new city, and she's trying to get comfortable with making friends and just being like a normal teenage girl. But she has she was born with HIV and no one knows, and she's trying to keep it under the table because people are really mean to her when they find out about it. And she does have a crush, and she would like to pursue that crush, but there is someone that found out about the fact that she has HIV, and they are blackmailing her. So she's trying to figure out how to handle all of that as a teenager and also live like a normal life. So I feel like it's going to be a really good read. I'm excited to get into it. Hopefully my attention span does not fail me. I'm going to try to stay off of Twitter, because if you don't know, right now it's BTS's comeback. So Twitter is just insane. I have one of my albums coming today. I'm getting the other two later tonight. So yeah, if you want to see anything about the comeback or how I feel about it, I'll link my K-pop channel up here so you can check it out. But other than that, we're going to get this reading vlog started. I have a few things to do today. Like, I want to read, and then I have to return books, and then I want to watch Waiting to Exhale because that's just one of my all-time favorites. And because it's Black History Month, I feel like I've been missing out on like the old school classic like Black movies, and I really just need to just heal my soul, because it's not often that I have like a Saturday off. So I'm trying to just like embrace and enjoy things that I love, and Waiting to Exhale is one of my favorite classic Black movies, so I'm gonna have to watch that. You already know. And then I have to go grocery shopping, and I have a couple of other things I have to do, so follow along with me if you like. I hope everybody's having a great month. Yeah, so let's go to the read shop. And I honestly want to go to the bookstore because I read A Blade So Black, and honestly I feel like that's one of my new favorite books, and I want to go pick up the second book because it's already out and I can't find it in the library. But I'm gonna go and either buy it or see if this library has it. So let's get into it. Let's go. Let's go to the read shop. too close. Okay. So I just got home. I had a lot of stuff that I had to do, and I did all of them, but I didn't film it because nobody wants to edit all of that. But I want to talk about full disclosure. I think I'm on like page 50. I think I'm like on the 50th page, and I really like it. I think it's going to be 5 stars. I really think it's going to be 5 stars. But like within like the first like 20 pages, I already learned so much about people that like have HIV and live with that illness. And just like, I still don't really know like the gist of like her family situation, because I know she has 2 fathers, which is just like, let's go diversity. But I don't really know like how she got it, or like where her mother is, or like what happened. So I'm interested to find out more about that. We got like a little girl group going on that's full of diversity. And then the MC is also into musicals, and she has a little crush, and it's just like so cute. And I love it so much so far. I think it's really cute. There's a lot of dialogue in it too, which I love, because I really like, I'm like a character driven reader, I guess, but I really like when there's a lot of dialogue and you get to really figure out who the character is without them actually telling you. So far, I really like it. It's really good. I feel like it's gonna be an amazing book, but we've already gotten to the plot twist where someone's already blackmailing her. She really likes this guy, and she's like about to go on a date with him, and she's super jittery and doesn't know what to do. And someone's already like left a note in her locker saying that they know that she has HIV, and they're gonna pretty much tell everyone and just out something that's her business, which is ridiculous. But I don't know, I'm interested to see how the story progresses. But I also got book mail. Publisher sent me A Phoenix Must First Burn. I'm so excited for this. Is this an arc? I think this is an arc. Oh, it's even prettier. Oh my god, look at it. It's even prettier in person. Oh my god. So this is pretty much like an anthology of like black teenagers, but with a sci-fi and like fantasy spin on them. And each, it's like a collab between multiple authors, and they each have like short stories in here. And you know how that goes. You always have some that you love and some that you don't like, but a lot of these authors in here are, I feel like this is like a safe space, because we have, let's see, who's in here? So I only know like 5 of these people on here, but I don't know. They're really good writers, so I feel like this is going to be good. I've seen a little bit of mixed reviews on this one, but I'm going to have my own opinion, okay? We're going to figure out how this goes. Let's see how many pages is on this thing. So it's like 340 pages or so. So this is a little, it's a thick boy, but I'm excited to get into this. This cover is gorgeous. I really like the way that a lot of the books right now are having like a lot of like illustrated editions, and they're really collabing with like new artists, because like this style, I've never seen anything like that. Like, look at that. It's so pretty. Yeah, I'm excited to read this. I don't know if I shouldn't start this now, because I'm already in the process of reading like 3 books, not near the end of any of those books, so I really shouldn't, but I probably am probably gonna do it anyway. Also, I went to Barnes & Noble because I wanted to get a Blade So Black 2. I'm not really sure what it's called. A Shade of something. A Shade of the Blade or some shit. I don't know. But I wanted to get the second book, and they did not have it. They didn't have it, and then the library was closed. So I really just, like, I told myself, you have books at home. Go home. And I went home, and I didn't buy any other books. Oh, my God. I'm so proud of myself. Like, that growth is just phenomenal. I thought of like 5 of the books I could have got, but I was just like, you're not gonna read this right now. Like, you're literally in the middle of like 4 other books, and you have so many other books to read. I'm trying to do this thing where I read the books that I already have. Who would have thought, you know? That's such a crazy idea, but I don't want to keep buying books and not reading them. So I'm just trying to be aware of what I spend my money on. So yeah, that was my day. But I'm about to watch Waiting to Exhale. I'm waiting for my package to get here, because I'm waiting on my BTS album, and I need to see which version I'm getting so that I can go get the other 2, because I was gonna wait for the ones I already ordered, but them things ain't getting here until Tuesday or Wednesday, and I'm not waiting, okay? I already got 1 album, and I'm gonna just go get the other 2. Hopefully I don't get the one that I got yesterday. The one I got yesterday was 3, and I'm not sure which one I'm getting today, but I guess I'll find out when it gets here, after I just said that I'm cautiously spending my money on things. Gonna watch this movie, and I also saw, I found this test that I want to take. It's called like what kind of child you would be if you were Beyonce's kid or some shit like that. I really want to take it. And then there's another one that's like, Are you Rihanna? Like, which Rihanna song are you, or something? I don't know. I think it's hilarious. I love taking BuzzFeed tests, so I think I'm gonna take one or both of those. I'm not sure, but yeah, that's where I'm at. I should read more, but I'm gonna watch this movie. So, bye.
K107 broadcasting on New Year's Eve. Why don't y'all scribble down those New Year's resolutions down here? Tell us those lies you're telling yourself. Promises you know you won't keep.
I don't believe in New Year's resolutions. You're stupid. I promise this year.
No matter what John says, this year I'm starting my catering business.
And if I do ever let Russell come back, I'm gonna whip something on him so I'm fast. Gonna
lose 10 pounds if you're right. 15 pounds.
Okay, 35. I mean,
35
pounds.
I'm going to the party, just not with you.
Nigga, what? This, oh, this
she,
man.
She.
Mm-mm, girl.
She doesn't want to be alone tonight, and I was thinking, why should she be?
Excuse me. Use that brush, girl. Use that brush.
And you picked tonight to flaunt your whore in front of all your business partners and your friends. What the hell are they supposed to think, John?
The truth. Finally, the truth. I'm leaving you for her.
This is a test of the emergency broadcast system.
This is only a test. Girl.
You can have the house and you know I'll take care of my kids.
Wait a minute. I give you 11 fucking years of my life, and you're telling me that you're leaving me for a white woman?
Would it be better if she were black?
No, it'd be better if you were black. This motherfucker is psychotic. Bitch, this serial killer's less anal.
Get your shit and get out. And all that shit right off.
It's against the law to burn anything except trash in your own yard, ma'am.
It is trash. Drinks are on you. Bye, motherfucker. See ya. Hello. It's me again. Okay, so honestly, I want to take these tests because I think they're going to be fun, but I think I'm going to do a separate video for those instead of trying to put it in the vlog because I already have a lot of stuff that I have to edit. It was a short vlog, but it was good. I had a good reading day yesterday. I got about 50, 60 pages into Full Disclosure, and I'm like 4 or 5. I think I'm like chapter 6 for Wish You All the Best, and it's taken everything in me. not to start given, which is down here. So yeah, I think I'm gonna end the vlog here, but I'm definitely gonna try to read some more, but I want to try to get this vlog up today so I don't have to have too much stuff to edit or take too long to edit it, because it just was one day, so we don't want to overdo it. But I really want to start this, like. And if you don't know what Given is about, it is about this warrior who is on a mission to find this cure for her father because her father just fell ill, and she has to go to a land that she's not familiar with. And when she goes there, she's very uncomfortable because it seems like people aren't used to people that look like her. She looks very different from everyone else, and where she came from, it was very welcoming. So this is a huge shock to her. And then she ended up meeting this shapeshifter that is her love interest, and he turns into a dragon, and he just like likes her so much, and she's just like, please stay away from me. But it seems like they're gonna like have a little friendship, and then it's gonna turn into a romance as they both go on this quest together. So I definitely want to start this. It's a little thick, and honestly, I'm right now in the middle of reading like 4 books, so I really want to wrap those books up so that I can start this one. But that's where I am right now. I also want to start reading, which is like a ton of anthologies and like fantasy short stories with a ton of authors that I talked about yesterday that I got from publishers, and I'm super excited. I got it from Penguin Teen. I think they're the ones that sent it to me. So Penguin Teen sent me this. Thank you so much. It's an ARC. And if you don't know what it's about, definitely go check it out on Goodreads. Add it to your TBR. But I want to start that one too. So I'm going to do my best to try to finish up the books that I'm currently reading, because I hate going into a new month with books that are not finished. It's like, it drives me crazy. So I'm going to try to finish those books. The audiobook, I feel like I should finish this week. Full disclosure, Riot Baby. So right now, I'm in the middle of reading Riot Baby, Full Disclosure, I Wish You All the Best on audiobook, and a fairy tale book that I started, but I'm not really in a rush to read that. That's just something that's like a children's book that I just picked up. And I think that's it. So those are all the books that I'm in the middle of reading right now. And I'm not even like in the middle of reading them. I'm like at the start of it. So I need to wrap that up. But yeah, I think I'm going to do the test for a different video. So stay tuned for that later this week. I also have another discussion video coming up with Steph, and she's a booktuber that I'm collabing with on this discussion video. So I still have to film my discussion video for that. But yeah, so I have the test coming up. I have the discussion video coming up. So if you don't know, I do like doing tests on my channel. I only have like maybe 5 or so videos with tests, but I really like doing them, especially the BuzzFeed ones. But the ones that I want to do this week are if you were Beyonce's child, this is what she would think of you. And I want to do which Rihanna outfit are you? So they have BuzzFeed tests for that, and I'm really excited because I think it's super fun. And if you don't know, for the month of February, all of my content is Black related, which is Melanin Book Magic A Year 2. Except Hobie's birthday. Hobie's birthday doesn't count because it's not his fault that his birthday is during Black History Month. And I gotta talk about my baby. Like, what did you expect? Aside from that, all of my content is Black or Black related. So that's why I tried to watch like old... I watched all of like the old Black movies today, and I had such a good time watching that and doing reviews. Like, Waiting to Exhale is just like... it's just a classic. Like, it's a classic. And Love Jones and Color Purple and just all my faves. So I just had a good day watching those, catching up on reviews, and I haven't read anything yet. But yeah, so I'm just gonna wrap this vlog here so I don't have too much to edit. I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know what you're reading. Let me know if you're reading multiple books and trying to finish them like I am, because your girl is struggling right now. I'm trying so hard because I don't want to start March with books pending. So gonna be working hard this week to finish those books. But thank you for watching. Always remember, read a book, keep your life interesting, and I will see you next time.